Have you ever wondered how final drive ratios got their weird numbers? 342, 373, 410, 411, and 456? Why not an easy number like 3.5 or 4? Well, it comes down to optimal gear design called hunting gears. With hunting gears, any given gear tooth on a drive gear will come in contact with every single tooth on the driven gear before reaching the starting point again. This has several benefits such as reduced noise, better break-in, and an even distribution of wear. If gear teeth were to come in contact with the same point more frequently, it would create a pattern that is more likely to generate a tone, so avoiding that as much as possible reduces noise. Spreading the contact around as much as possible keeps any one tooth pair from wearing an unusual pattern into each other, making failure less likely, or at least pushed to a later date. So how does an engineer come up with a new hunting gear tooth count? Well, the math is pretty straightforward. Make sure that the drive gear and the driven gear tooth counts have no common factors. For example, a gear with 10 teeth driving a gear with 40 teeth share factors of 2, 5, and 10. Not a good gear pairing there. However, a gear with 10 teeth driving gear with 41 teeth share no factors, so the math checks out for these. This gets us the 410 gear ratio I mentioned at the beginning of the video. Hunting gears can be found in other places in vehicles too. Transmission gears often implement a hunting gear setup for the same reasons we've talked about already. Cams, however, those are forced to run at a 2-to-1 ratio in order for the engine to run properly, so they can't be hunting gears, right? Because most cams are driven by belts and chains, it's actually possible for a hunting pattern to be implemented. The chain needs to have a number of links that aren't divisible by the number of teeth on either gear, and same goes for the teeth on the timing belt. The length of the belt or chain doesn't affect the gear ratio at all, so engineers just have to make sure the belt or chain has the right number of teeth for the gears and the distance it needs to travel from one gear to the other, and then a tensioner can handle the slack left in the system. Using prime numbers is a pretty common method for quickly finding hunting gear ratios, so engineering these gear systems aren't wild guessing games until a cooperative pair is found. Still, it's a fascinating bit of automotive math that keeps gears working with minimal issues. The only big downside to them is that someone has to come up with a hunting gear pair and engineer a design around them instead of designing a component and then selecting whatever size gears happen to fit in well with a decent enough ratio. For most people watching, all the hard work has been done for them, but if you're an aspiring engine designer, driveline engineer, or gear machinist, I wish you the best of luck.